Hey, how's it going, guys? This is Ekiman, and today we are going to be taking a look at Banished. So this is a new game that just came out on Steam this week. It's a city builder game, and I've been having a lot of fun with it while I've been playing, so I thought we'd do a bit of a let's play on this. So let's get started. First thing we want to do is rename this Hadley's Hope, seeing as that's what we generally call our colony on Rimworld, so we're going to keep that going, Hadley's Hope, and we'll go with that seed, whatever it is. Valleys, large, fair, on, and stack conditions, medium. That seems okay to me. So yeah, let's jump straight into this. Like I say, it's a lot of fun. I'm really enjoying playing this. I've done a couple of towns already that have gone okay, but I didn't want to go too far into the game because obviously I wanted to do a let's play on this. So yeah, first thing we're going to do once the game loads in is a little bit of town planning, sort of lay out how we want things to work here. And this seems, yeah, this seems like a reasonable start. We can do some fishing. We've got some forest areas. That seems okay. Let me just take a note of the time here. Okay. Right, so first thing I want to do, like I say, is a little bit of town planning. So let's get a market, and we're not going to build this straight away. We're just going to place it down like so, and then pause the building of it. We also want to do, let's have a road around this thing. There we go, and then we also want to join that up to there. Before we get started as well, actually, let's open up some information tabs. So we've got our profession screen there, we've got our event log, which is going to let us know when villagers die off, and yeah, we've got some basic information about our town here as well. One second, let me just check the volume. Let's just turn that down a little bit. There we go. Okay, so first thing we want to do is start thinking about some food production and some resource production. So we're going to get a forester's lodge going first. Let's just take a look at how this is going to work. Yeah, we're going to get a bit of wasted space, but I'm not really too worried about that. We're not playing exactly for efficiency. I just want to line this up with the road mainly, so let's just try and get it. Okay, well, let's just lay a road down so we know where we're going, I guess. So we want to start there, and we want to take a road right out to there. We can always change that at a later date. Right, so now we know where the road is, and we can do this in line with our colony. So let's get a forester lodge and figure out where the end of the road is. Actually, let me just zoom out a bit here. Okay. So around about there seems like a good place. Okay, so we'll place that down there. That is our forester lodge, and we also want to get a gatherer hut. So let's get that placed down as well. This is going to provide our village with food. We'll place that next to the forester lodge. And then we're going to need a couple of buildings here. Actually, yeah, we should maybe think about... Okay, so we want to place a couple of houses here opposite where we're going to be working. That should do us. Two houses there. And do we want to pause production on these? No, we don't. Not yet, anyway. So okay, so we do want to just extend our road slightly, just so I know where our grid's going to be. Put one there. Oops. And we'll do that. We're going to have this town market be the center of our village, or our main area anyway. And let's just stretch it out a couple of blocks that way as well. Okay, so we actually need, I think we need 3 houses to home all our villagers. So let's get those placed now. There we go, and one more. It should do us, but let's just pause construction on these. Because as you can see, we need more builders than we have laborers. So if we pause those and assign 9 builders, there we go. And yeah, I think we're going to speed this up to times 10 just for the sake of pacing in this video. Normally I would play a little bit slower than this. Wait, oh yeah, they're building a road. So once they've done that, they're going to move down here. They're going to chop down stuff as they go. And then hopefully they will start work on, yeah, on our Forester Lodge and various stuff like that. So they're just going to ferry some supplies back and forth here. And then once we've got these built up, we're going to assign some workers and hopefully start producing some much needed resources. So we need to get... We need to get things in order before winter. You can see we're in spring here, but as soon as winter hits, things are going to get very cold. And our villagers, they're going to need somewhere to stay. They're going to need to keep warm. So once we've got this in place, we're going to work on putting in... What are we going to put in next? Where are we at? There we go. We're going to put in a woodcutter. So let's actually place that down, but we're going to pause construction on that because I don't exactly want to get started. Okay, so we have now got a gatherer's hut and a forester lodge working, so we can reduce the amount of builders we have for now anyway. And we're going to put we're going to put 2 gatherers to work, and I guess we'll do 2 foresters as well, and we'll let them go about building. Actually, we could probably set one of these going as well. We'll assign 2 more to that. There we go. Yeah, so you want to have buildings nearby where you've got things like this so that your workers have somewhere to stay. Actually, we might put down a hunting lodge as well, and maybe an extra building, but we should be okay for now, I think. And one of our children has just matured. You can see that here, has become an adult and is now working as a labourer. And we've got a surplus of builders, so let's just get these going as well. We're going to assign 1 more gatherer and 1 more forester. Okay, so they're going to throw those buildings up, and soon enough everyone should have their own home. You can see here, if they've got a little house icon over their head, they do not have a home to live in. We can actually make a crop field, but for now we're not going to start off with that because they are only active during sort of the summer months. During the winter, we're not producing any food, whereas a gatherer's hut is working all year round. So we want to keep that going as long as possible. But I think we are going to think about putting in a hunting cabin, I should say. There we go. And again, we've actually got a surplus of builders, so we can unpause the woodcutters. We're going to need the woodcutter. He's going to take logs and turn them into firewood so that our homes can stay warm. And we might actually think about extending our road slightly as well. So let's just do that. And find the edge. There we go. So we want to go to there. Reserve of stone is low. Our foresters, they're going to actually remove stone and iron in the area, so that shouldn't be too much of a problem, but just for the sake of this, we're going to select this, and we're actually going to collect some stone from the area, so let's highlight that. And yeah, once we've got, there we go, we can reduce our builders to 3 now. We want to put one guy in as a woodcutter, though. He's going to start supplying firewood for our homes. We can set a limit on them. And our laborers, they should go about mining this stone out. Actually, maybe we can... No, I'm going to keep it on 10 times speed. We may slow it down here and there, just when we want to work on some stuff. Hey, we've got some deer there. Okay, so our hunting cabin is going up. We should maybe think about putting in an extra house for people who are going to work in the hunting cabin. There we go. And you can actually check these to see how many people are living in them. See, we've got... one child and 3 adults. Basically, we want to try and have 2 adults in every home, because then they will breed and we'll get more villagers. But we don't really want too many villagers early on. We want to sort of establish ourselves and get a nice supply of food and logs and all that good stuff. So I know we've got 2 labourers here. We could assign them to be builders, but I'm going to leave them as labourers because we need some stone. Actually, we've got a nice chunk of stone there, so let's assign 2 people to the hunting cabin. We'll take 1 person off of building, and maybe we'll put them down as a gatherer because we need some food. As you can see here, we've only got 92 stored food, so we need people to be working on that. And we are coming into late autumn, so yeah, we're getting a bit of snow now, and our woodcutter is now, he's actually hit the max limit for the fuel, so yeah, we've got enough firewood now for the homes. These guys are now working on putting up another house. And the number of houses you have directly relates to how many villagers we're going to get. The more houses we have, the more breeding is going to go on. So here we go. We've got 2 people here and 2 children. 2 and 2 children. Oh, they've got 3 kids. Right. Well, that's good. That's what we want. And how are they doing? They've still got 3 in there. And they've got 3 in there as well. So we could maybe do with... Now that house should cover us, shouldn't it? They'll move out, and then we should have another child as well. So we will have enough houses to go with, to get on with there, and we're doing okay for food. Not too bad at all. Firewood's doing good. We are getting a bit low on the logs, so what we might actually do is, once they have finished building this house, which they need certain items for before they do that, we might cut down a few trees and collect some... actually, let's select that now. Yeah, this one, remove resources. This is going to take everything in this area out for us. So let's just get that. That should give us a good start. So yeah, this is quite a challenging game. The idea is to try and expand as much as possible and keep everyone alive as long as possible, basically. There's no combat in the game, there's no tech trees, you can build anything at any time. And the challenge comes in keeping your colony alive as long as possible. I think we're going to put in a fishing hut down here as well. Once these guys are finished doing that... And there we go. No one's moved into it yet, but... Oh, there you go. Now they have. So they should have 2 in there. Yes, they do. They've got 2 in there. Brilliant. We're doing okay here. 12 adults, 9 kids. And we no longer need those builders. Actually, no, we probably will do, because I want to put in another form of food. So we're going to put in a fishing dock here. And let's just try and line this up. Oops. And we want to put it about here. That should do us. And then we also want to put in a road. Like so. And then we want to join this up to here. There we go. And then our workers have a faster way of getting about. And we're going to set the market building pretty soon as well. What the market does is it fairly distributes your food and resources to the houses within this radius. So otherwise, what's going to happen is people in these houses, they're going to go straight to the storage barn and take as many resources as they can carry. And obviously, we don't entirely want that to happen, because some people are going to be left without food. So yeah, we had one labourer. We're going to put him on hunting. That's going to supply us with food and leather all year round. And we're going to need the leather to make some clothes. Now, clothes are going to keep our villagers warm so that they can work outside for longer before they have to go home. One thing I want to do is we can check where people are living. Okay, so the woodcutters living nearby, that's good. Now this is a bit of a problem. We could maybe do with another house out here. Another house. Yeah, so some of our workers, they're having to walk quite a distance to get to work. Just check how long we've got left. We've got about another 5 minutes left, so this is a pretty good start for us, I think. I'm quite happy with how we're going here. We've survived our first winter. We've got a decent amount of food here. Got an extra labourer, so where do I want to put my extra labourer? I think we're going to put them into Forester. And we might also think about putting another Forester Lodge down. So let's just see what the radius is there. We might put one in around here. Okay, we've got another labourer available, but nowhere to really put them. So what we're going to do is we're going to put in a I'm going to put in a blacksmith's, I think, if we can fit it in here. We can't fit it right there, so that's fine. We'll put it over the road here. Yeah, we're going to put that right there. Increase our builders to 4. And we're actually reaching our capacity here, so I think what we're going to do is unpause the market. Although that's going to require a lot more builders than we have available. Maybe we could... Oh no, they're taking stuff. That's fine. We were reaching capacity with our storage area here, but as you can see, our villagers are taking the materials and starting to build our market, which is good. Another child has been born, so we're doing okay. We're going to start thinking about a little bit of expansion, probably in the next episode. We still don't have our fishing dock up. Which reminds me, let's have a look here. There we go. We can also put in trading posts. Oop, turn that around. Yeah, we can't put one there. Oh, that's good. We can put one on this side of the fishing hut. We'll do that at a later time, though. I don't want to worry too much about trading right now. But basically, we can take some of our supplies here and trade them for seeds and livestock, and then we can create ourselves pastures and farming areas. But for now, like I say, we're going to work with what we have with the gatherers and the hunters. They should do us okay for a while. As you can see, we're building up a good amount of food, but we are going to want to get that much, much higher. And then we can start expanding our town. And there we go, we now have a market in place, but we're going to need a vendor, so we'll take one person off of building, and we'll put one person in the market. And yeah, they're going to start filling up this inventory from the storage barn with food and things like that. And we've hit our limit on firewood, but that's good. We don't need any more than that right now. So everything is... Oh, reserve of tools is getting low, so it's probably a good time for us to get our blacksmith up and running. What are we waiting for there? Stone, iron, logs. Are they starting work on it yet? No, they're probably going to work on the fishing dock. I don't know what they're building right now. Well, we're not going to worry about that too much. They should start work on it pretty soon, hopefully. I guess they're still clearing out this area. Yes, they are. We've got another labourer. Let's put him down as a builder. Or her. Not really sure what who it was. Fours. Could be either, really. tell you what, let's pause the fishing dock right now, because I want them to focus on getting the blacksmiths up and running. We are running a little bit low on tools. The next thing we're going to think about building is a tailor, because once again we're running out of stored clothes as well, so maybe we can... Yeah, we're nearing capacity again. Tailors, there we go. Can we fit that in here? No, we can't. We maybe should have thought about this a bit better, but we could actually put it there, couldn't we? And we've got some spare people. We'll have them work as general labourers, and then if anyone should die, our general labourers will replace them. How's our market doing? 25% done. That's not too bad. Maybe we're going to put in a temporary stockpile. Where do we want to put in our temporary stockpile? We could actually remove this stockpile and put a fresh one in, but I don't want to do that just now. Let's just put a secondary one in right here. That should allow us to store some more items. And there we go, the blacksmith's is going up. We can check progress on that, as you can see here. So 17% complete on that. We're doing okay. I think we're doing good. 17 adults, 6 kids. That's fine. Oops, I didn't want to close that screen down. There we go. And once we've got the blacksmiths up, we're going to turn one of our labourers into a blacksmith worker. And then I think that is probably a good point for us to end the episode at. If I'm just... check the clock. I think we've been going about 20 minutes. There we go. Okay, so the blacksmith is now ready. So we're going to put one person working in there. He's going to produce us some more tools. And the next thing we want to think about is, obviously, we want to get this fishing dock done. So we're going to unpause that. And we'll probably put in a tailor's. But yeah, I'm going to call this the end of the episode, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this first episode of Banished. I hope you do anyway. RimWorld seems to do quite okay, and this is a similar sort of game. Obviously, just without the combat, we've just got to worry about survival. But yeah, I'm going to call this the end of the episode, guys. As always, I really hope you've enjoyed watching this. I'm out for now, and I will see you soon for some more Banished. Peace.